And you could argue that maybe this is already being talked about as a big deal and overreacted to, but the Dallas Cowboys and the Dak Prescott injury, the shoulder injury, I feel like a lot of the talk, especially coming from the Dallas Cowboys, is like, don't worry about it. This is preseason.
Yeah.
This is, you know, we're seeing Matt Stafford not play at all. Aaron Rodgers won't play at all. Yeah, he's a little dinged up, but it's not that big a deal. Dak Prescott, week one, will be out there. Do you agree that that reaction's appropriate, or are we underreacting to the significance of this Dak Prescott injury?
I think from the get-go, I've been pretty standard here. I still think we're underreacting to this injury. I do, yes. I mean, from the base, like, point I would make right off the bat, and I said this to Florio a few weeks on PFT when he first heard it, or we first heard about the injury. Like, and I'm not trying to be a jerk here. I challenge any listener out there. I don't know and cannot think, and I haven't Googled it or anything like that. I've never heard of a quarterback pulling their lat muscle. That is a really, really rare quarterback injury, if ever, right? And that's more of a baseball type of injury. And I kind of went over this with Florio because, you know, baseball, as you know, you're pitching off a mound.
Yep.
Your body's fully extended like this. It's a different motion than a quarterback where he's holding the ball up here and not, you know, extending himself to the level of a Clayton Kershaw or some of those guys. Yep. So that's where I think we're underreacting to it a little bit. You know, and of course it is his throwing shoulder, and he has a lower leg injury to go along with it on the same side of that throwing shoulder, where I don't know if he's using the full force of his leg to push off. And here's the last thing I'll say. You know, of course, a lot of their season and the way it goes is dictated by him. I mean, they're a passing team. It's his team. You know, the run game, all those things. Hey, great. No, it's going to be about Dak Prescott throwing the football. We know their defense will be better, but I don't expect it to be top 10 or anything like that. But the one thing I went back and looked at this, and you everybody who listens to me, you know, I'm a psycho about quarterback mechanics and things and all of that. I, from the first time I saw him throw this offseason, thought it looked different than the years I've seen Dak Prescott the last few years in the NFL back to Mississippi State. And when I went back and compared film from last year before his injury and some of the throws I've seen on Hard Knocks and things like that, to me there is a little bit of a difference in the way he's throwing. And that's where I think people are underreacting. And not that I'm like, hey, I'm rooting for Dak. You know that. I'm a Prescott fan. Yeah. I've been on he's a top 10 quarterback in football here for the last 3 years. But I am concerned when your team is going to be based around throwing the football. You haven't played in a year. You have a lower leg injury that is part of pushing off and helping you gain power. And now I see a little bit something different in your throwing motion. See, and it's really, listen, it's tough. And I do consider myself a trained eye. You're not going to see it much if you're watching the rollout throws. But here, like, these are the throws I notice it. There is, and I'm going to like kind of demonstrate this. There's a little bit more of a verticalness to his release that he did not have, at least in my opinion, before the injury. Hmm. And so before the injury.
Is that a bad thing? Is that necessarily a bad thing?
It's not necessarily a bad thing, but if you've been throwing one way your whole life and now you're making up a new way and asking a different muscle pattern to be, you know, I need this muscle pattern now to help me throw the ball hard or far or do those type of things.
You're recruiting different muscles.
That worries me a little. Yeah, yeah. And especially, like, a lat. All my years, you can ask anybody. I was like the guy who was like, hey, you're throwing too much. I never had my lat feel sore, ever, ever throwing a football. And so here is what I hope people are watching on YouTube and everything like that. But here's, to me, the little bit of the difference in the motion, okay? You know, Dak Prescott last year, when I watched film before the injury, you know, it's kind of traditional. It may be not as round as much as I talk about, but the takeaway was more like this, right? You know, traditional, take it away, slot the arm perfectly, use the body, and then throw, okay? What I see right now, and even what we saw just like one or two of those clips, is a little bit of a motion to get up like this. And that, to me, is what would anchor your lat into the throw. Yeah. There's a little bit more of this, you know, ball drops for a second, and then it goes straight up instead of, wait, before it used to be just right here in the middle of his chest and he would kind of pull away and it was a nice seamless smooth motion. You know, again, he's still going to be good throwing this new way and all that. I think it's probably something that he created early on when he was getting back from rehab because he couldn't push off. So he was trying to throw, and then to put a little bit extra mustard on it, he found out, wait, if I can get a little higher here and do that, I can throw it maybe the way I want and get the results I want, but it's not necessarily best for his body. So I'm just going to continue to keep my eye on that. I said at the get-go when he hurt this, I said, this will not be like a 2 or 3 day where he'll be out of practice for 2 or 3 days. Yeah. I told Florio then, I was like, I bet you that's not the case. Yeah. And we went 10 days at least without him throwing.
Because it's more troubling because you wonder how'd you get that? What happened and what changed to give you that injury?
There were some Hail Marys in practice.
Total sense.
So he stressed it that way.
It makes total sense that if he's not recruiting the lower leg muscles as much,
right,
and he has to overcompensate.
And then you're changing the upper leg.
Which is why they take a pitcher out of a game when he's been hitting the leg sometimes, or he has a hamstring injury. You go, well, what does that have to do with anything? Well, it changes everything.
Exactly right. Now he's compensating for that being hurt, so now he's using another muscle, and then all of a sudden you get off the mound and you go, my right hip hurts. And you're like, you go back and watch film, and you go, well, that's why. I can't push off with the other, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
You're right. It changes it that way. Plus being the fact that his arm is probably not as in good shape as it usually is because he had to do rehab and all those type of things. Okay. So, again, I'm not like – I don't want to overly react.
Sure. Okay,
but I'm saying let's keep our eye on this a little bit.
All right, so let's fire up the fearometer.
The fearometer?
How fearful are you that this could linger into a week – you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 thing.
Well, as we sit here Wednesday, McCarthy is already saying he doubts they're going to see Dak Prescott this weekend in the Texans preseason game for preseason game number 2, right? And I understand it. I think they understand this is rare, and there's a reason why you heard that they talked to the Yankees and the Texas Rangers because they were probably like, I've never had a quarterback pull this muscle.
Yeah.
And they had to reach out to baseball people to do that. The fearometer,
yeah,
like fearometer. If 10 was like, oh my gosh, I'm so fearful.
Yeah.
I'm like right down the middle right now. It's 5.
Okay.
But I just think we all got to kind of still continue to gauge this and watch this because of the rarity of the injury for a thrower.
Sure. And their Twitter account has tried to tell us not to worry. It's not a setback.
But they've
and
been saying that from all,
freaks everyone out when you're like, why did you just tweet that? Right.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.